Hi students, 12th standard computer application chapter 11 network examples and protocols. In this video we are going to learn about OSI model, that is open system interconnection, 7 layers, and what is TCP/IP and some other protocols. Now let us start.
Reference model, the first one OSI model. So here OSI stands for Open System Interconnection. So this model was found in year 1934. So the general framework that enables the network protocol along with the software and systems to be developed based on the general set of guidelines. So it described the standard for the inter-computer communication. So there are many prompts used to remember the OSI layer order. Everyone needs data processing and everyone should try new Diet Pepsi. So OSI layers. So we have seven layers, that is physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer and application layer. Now let us see one by one. The first one, physical layer. So this is the first layer. It defines the electrical and physical specifications for devices. So we can use, it can define that electrical and physical specification. And second one, data link layer. It is the second layer and it is guarantees that the data transmitted are free of errors. And this layer has a simple protocols like 802.3 for Ethernet and 802.11 for Wi-Fi. And third layer, network layer. It is a third layer determining the path of the data packets. So it determines the path of data packets. So at this layer, the routing of data packets is found using IP addressing. And next, transport layer. It is a fourth layer that guarantees the transportation sending of data is successful. So it includes the error checking operation. And session layer, it is the fifth layer. It identifies the establishment system session between a different network entities. And it controls the dialogues between computers. For instance, while accessing a system remotely, a session is created between your computer and the remote system. Next, presentation layer. It is the sixth layer and that does the translation of data to the next layer. That is, prepare the data to the application layer. We can prepare the data and we can send it to the next layer. So here, encryption and decryption protocols occurs in this layer, like SSL. Secure socket layer. So here it protects the data. Encryption means just we are going to protect the data. And application layer, it is the seventh layer which act as the user interface platform comprising of softwares within the system. So these are all the seven layers. Now let us see some functions and example protocols, everything. So first, physical layer. Here we used Bluetooth, Ethernet, DSL, Wi-Fi, ISDN, everything. And data link layer, switches, ARP, ATM, CDP, FDDI, frame relay, and STP, token ring, everything. And network layer, routers, layer 3 switches, etc. IPv4, that is Internet Protocol 4 and Internet Protocol 6. And then transport layer, here TCP, UDP, and session layer, NFS, PAP, SCP, and presentation layer, we used JPEG, MIDI, MPEG, PACT, TIFF, GIF. And last, application layer, here the function is services affecting end user application. So that is SMTP, that is simple mail transfer protocol. We can transfer the information. What is TCP/IP? TCP full form Transmission Control Protocol, and IP stands for Internet Protocol. So it is a set of protocol. It governs a communication among all the computers on the internet. We can communicate with the computer on the internet. And TCP IP protocol tells how the information should be packaged, sent and received, as well as how to get its destination. So we can send the data, we can receive, and then we can know that how to get the its destination, everything. And TCP IP is a combination of two protocols, that is TCP and IP. The internet protocol, it specifies the logistics of the packets that are sent out over networks. It specifies the packets which have to go and where to go and how to get there. So the transmission control protocol is accountable for guaranteeing the trustworthy transmission of data, and it checks if any packet is not transmitted and submits it again. And so frequent TCP/IP protocols are HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. It is used between a web client and a web server, and it guarantees a non-secure data transmission. And second one, HTTPS, Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure. Here, it is used between a web client and web server. It ensures a secure data transmission. And next, FTP, File Transfer Protocol. It used between a computers for sending and receiving the files. Domain names and TCP IP addresses. So here the address for any website is not easy to remember. So instead of that, we use a domain name. So for example, 216.58.216.164 is one of the IP address for Google, and google.com is the domain name. So by the help of domain name, we can identify easily. When we use a website, domain name is easy. IP address means it is difficult to remember that numbers. Different layers of TCP/IP. So here in OSI model, we studied 7 layers. In TCP/IP, we used 4 layers, each of which is listed below the description. So here, the first one is network access layer. It concerned with building packets. And second, internet layer. It describes how packets are to be delivered. And transport layer, it ensures the proper transmission of data. And application layer, application network processes. So these process includes FTP, file transfer protocol, and hypertext transfer protocol, and simple mail transfer protocol. Other network protocols. So the network protocols other than OSI and TCP were simply known as other network protocol. It implements the security through the network communication that include HTTPS, SSL, SFTP. So other networks similarly classified into network layer, IP, ARP, ICMP, IGMP. At transport layer, we use TCP and UDP. At application layer, HTTP, FTP, Telnet, SMTP and DNS. So HTTPS is of a hypertext transfer protocol secure. It is a protocol where encoded data transfer on a secure connection. So this HTTPS makes a data more and provide a data security over the internet, mainly on public networks like Wi-Fi. So here in OSI, we used a physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, and application layer. In TCP/IP model, we used network access layer, internet layer, transport layer, and application layer. So the first one, network interface layer. Here, Ethernet, token ring, and other link layer protocols. So it is the bottommost level layer, and it is comparable to that the open system interconnection, physical and data link layers. And different TCP/IP protocols are being used at this layer, and Ethernet and token ring for local area networks, and protocols like X.25, frame relay, and ATM for wide area networks. It is consumed to be an unreliable layer. Next one is network layer. Here, it is the layer where data is addressed, packaged, and routed among the networks. So, the important internet protocol that operate at the network layers are the first one, IP, internet protocol, which uses IP addresses to deliver packets. And it is an unreliable protocol, does not guarantee deliver of information. Next, address resolution protocol, ARP. It resolves the IP addresses to MAC address. MAC means stands for a medium access control. So MAC address is the hardware identification number that uniquely identify each device on the internet network. So to map IP network address to the hardware address. And next, ICMP, that is Internet Control Message Protocol. It is used by a network device to send error messages and operational informations. Example, a host or router might not be reached or requested service is not presented. And next, IGMP, Internet Group Management Protocol. It is a communication protocol used by the host and routers to send multicast, that is group communication messages to multiple IP address at once. You can share a group communication. The next one is transport layer. So the sessions are recognized and data packets are swapped between host in this layer. The two main protocols are used in this layer. One is TCP, another one is UDP. TCP means Transmission Control Protocol. So it provides a reliable connection oriented transmission between two hosts. So it ensures delivery of packets between the host. And UDP, User Datagram Pack Protocol, it provides the connectionless, unreliable one-to-one or one-to-many delivery. And next, application layer. Here, the application layer of TCP/IP model is, it is similar to session layer and presentation layer and application layer of OSI reference model. So the most popular application layer protocols are HTTP, the core protocol of the World Wide Web, and FTP. It enables the client to send and receive a complete files from the server, and Telnet, it connect to another computer on the internet, and SMTP, it provide a email service, and DNS, domain name system, it refers to the other host computers by using names rather than numbers. So these are all the TCP/IP protocols. Thank you, students.